Hello everyone. Welcome to the 23rd video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. In this video, I will teach you how to use keyframe interpolation. In simple words, with keyframe interpolation, we can set the direction and type of movement between keyframes. Now I create an animation for these two logos. I select both layers of the logo and press the letter P to activate the position. I create three keyframes for each logo and change the location of the logo. In this way, I created the animation of the logos. I put the time indicator on frame 2 seconds and 15 frames and press the letter N to shorten the work area. And I hit the play button. Now, every time I click on the logos layer, I can see their path. Also, according to the number of keyframes created for each layer over time, squares are made on the track. I right-click on the middle keyframe and select keyframe interpolation. You can see that by default the auto bezier option is selected in front of spatial interpolation, which is why the path created is curved. Now, if I select the linear option and press the OK button, the path will be created in broken form. I press the play button to see the change made. Now, if you want the default keyframes to always be linear, from the Edit menu, select Preferences and then General. In this section, activate the default spatial interpolation to linear option and press the OK button. In this way, linear keyframes are created by default for layers. Note that now we only change the middle keyframe to linear, and the beginning and end keyframes are auto bezier. In this case, there is a handle for the keyframe that we can move and drag to change the logo movement path. By selecting the last keyframe as well, we can drag the handle and change the movement of the logo. Because we chose the linear option for the middle keyframe, there is no category for it. By right-clicking and selecting the Bezier option, two categories will be created for the keyframe, and we can move each category separately. By using this method, we can make many and smooth changes. But auto bezier mode makes a smooth transition through a keyframe, and the handles change in the opposite direction to maintain a smooth transition between keyframes. If after making the changes you want the movement path of the keyframes to return to the previous state, select the desired keyframes and right-click, then click on keyframe interpolation, and select the auto bezier option. The continuous bezier option smooths the speed of a keyframe, but it also allows us to set the handles. I select the linear option again and press the OK button. We can also change the direction of movement by using the Convert Vertex tool and dragging on the squares. And if you click on the squares with this tool, the keyframe will change between linear and bezier. And with the help of the selection tool, we can change the location of the squares, which causes a change in the speed and direction of the keyframe. But as you can see, the time value of the keyframe does not change in the timeline. I select the keyframe interpolation option again. In front of the temporal interpolation option, we can choose different types of keyframes and see the changes in the timeline. I select Bezier and press OK. You can see that the shape of the keyframe has changed, but the path of the logo has not changed. Now I click on the graph editor that I taught in the previous lesson. Here I choose Speed Graph. Now I can change the logo movement speed by dragging the nodes. I select keyframe interpolation again. For example, I choose the linear option, and you can see its effect on the selected node. We can also choose the options in the temporal interpolation section in the timeline panel. In the timeline panel, we can separate the handles of a node by selecting the linear keyframe. Doing this changes the speed at the beginning and end of a keyframe. If you select the auto bezier option for nodes, it is not possible to separate the movement of the handles in the timeline. By selecting the hold option, the logo stops in the middle of the path and jumps to the next keyframe. Therefore, the temporal interpolation option applies keyframe changes to time in the timeline panel. And the spatial interpolation option changes the shape of an object's path in the composition panel. In the keyframe interpolation rove across time section, there is another option called rove across time. By choosing this option, the timing of the selected keyframes will be freed to create a smooth and unchanged speed. Pay attention to the points on the path. In this case, the points are placed on the track at the same distance from each other, which makes the speed smooth and unchanged. The closer these points are to each other, the slower the movement speed, and the farther they are, the faster the speed. By selecting the look to time option, the timing of the selected keyframe is created based on the time of the keyframe in the timeline. Now you can see that by changing the location of the keyframe in the timeline, the distance between the points on the path changes, and as I explained, it causes the speed of the keyframe to change. To get to know more about the graph editor, I recommend that you definitely see lesson 22. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I see you next time.